In India, there exists an ancient learning tradition that is practiced by more than 20,000 Tibetan Buddhist monks and nuns. They are followers of His Holiness the Dalai Lama. And in 1999, the Dalai Lama announced a vision for the exiled Tibetan monastic community to engage science and to initiate science trainings in order to support new learning at the frontiers of science and spirituality. Shortly following, the Sagar Family Foundation partnered with the Library of Tibetan Works and Archives in Dharamshala, India, to fulfill a personal request of the Dalai Lama. This historic partnership and project would later be named Science for Monks. What science do monks and nuns learn? Topics of common interest to both science and Buddhist traditions, where both traditions provide provocative counterpoints. Studying other philosophical traditions to deepen one's own insights has deep roots in Indian Buddhism, going back to the time of Nalanda in the 6th century. In 2010, Bobby Sagar, the president and founder of the Sagar Family Foundation, met with His Holiness the Dalai Lama and talked about the future role of science education in the monastic community.
The most effective and something that's according to...
In ancient times, which is the Tibetan tradition, or I think not in the tradition, although Buddhist institution, but study all non-Buddhist school of thought.
Right.
So now, modern time, the science is very, very important. So it must include, modernize. Can be on the basis of Nalanda tradition, add some new things, so modernize, up to date sort of higher standard of education.
A conscious effort was made to engage the monastics in science without disrupting traditional Buddhist studies. In 2000, the first annual 4-week-long intensive science workshop was organized by the Tibetan Library for 50 Buddhist scholars representing all the major traditions within Tibetan Buddhism. The first workshop provided a general introduction to the physical sciences, and each subsequent workshop further identified topics of common interest. Topics have included neuroscience, cosmology, and the scientific inquiry into content ranging from natural phenomena to individual sensory perception. Guided inquiry and hands-on activities were essential to the learning and the group dialogue by providing common experiences and a starting point for exchanges of ideas. Each workshop took place at a center of learning within the exiled community. By 2007, there was a growing enthusiasm for science within the monastic community. Many of the same monks returned each year, and after 9 consecutive workshops, over 200 monastics had been introduced to science through the science workshops. In 2008, the Sagar Science Leadership Institute was created to train the monastics in the skills and tools they would need to share science with their colleagues. An important part of their work was learning how to tinker with materials. Here, they attempted to gauge crater sizes based on the size and the distance the objects were dropped from. Cosmology activities have also explored the size and history of the solar system and the universe. These have led to lengthy and often intense debates. In neuroscience, activities have focused on sensory perception and investigating how our different senses work together to create our perception of the world. Group work and group projects are an important part of the program. Monastics meet in groups to further their own learning and develop leadership skills. Working in groups, the monastics share and improve their writing, answer each other's questions about science, plan science lessons, and create exhibitions on science and Buddhism. In 1999, the first science exhibition by Tibetan monastics was presented in Dharamshala, India. During the three-day event, hundreds of local Tibetan students and many government officials came to see the monastics present their perspective on the intersections of Buddhism and science. Following the success of this exhibition, a second exhibition on sensory perception was created, working with educators and museum professionals from the Smithsonian Institution and the Exploratorium. The monastics designed an exhibit that shared both Buddhist and Western scientific understanding of each of the five senses. His Holiness the Dalai Lama inaugurated the exhibit in New Delhi in November 2010.
Science lesson now eventually introduced in the main curriculum. Or monastery. Then teacher automatically to Tibetan.
The Sagar Science Leadership Institute provides the training and resources necessary for Tibetan monastics to share science with their community. Like scientists, the monastics are deeply curious about how the world works. For them, engaging scientists in inquiry is a natural step that can provide new insights and discoveries at the interface of science and spirituality.